Hello, Benedetta. It's lovely to chat to you for She Can today. Tell us a little about yourself and what you do.
Hello, Stephanie. Lovely to see you. So, I'm a dermatologist. I'm Italian. At the moment, I live between London and Florence. And I work in both countries. What can I say? So I'm a mother, I have two children, and I'm living in the countryside in lockdown, since lockdown, and working in the city. So it's been, let's say, quite a tough year and a half. I know exactly what you would like me to tell you about myself.
I'll ask you the question, so you just have to answer. Okay. Benedetta, I'm interested in how did you get to the point where you are today? When did you know you wanted to be a dermatologist, and what was your journey to be where you are today?
Okay, so I studied in Florence. I was in medical school. And since, let's say, halfway through my medical school, I loved being a surgeon. When I was studying in Italy, becoming a general surgeon for a woman in the 1990s was a huge challenge. So after lots of thought, I decided that maybe the best thing for me was to become a dermatologist, which is a very surgical specialty, but much easier for a good balance to be able to be a mother, to be able to be a doctor, a professional, have a career, and much better work and life balance. So when I was in my last year of medical school, I started applying for the specialty in dermatology. And I was lucky enough to get in straight away. So I specialized in Florence, and I had a fantastic professor, Professor Torello Lotti, that gave me the opportunity to have experiences abroad during my 4 years of dermatology. So I was able to go and work in Berlin. I was able to go and work in San Diego and visit lots of other dermatology departments around the world, thanks to him. This let me learn modern technologies, learn laser treatments that were, you know, just coming out at the time, and cosmetic dermatology that was quite new at the end of the 90s. I became a dermatologist. I had my job in Florence, my private clinic. I was a researcher at the university. And then it happened that I met my husband. He's English and he lived in London. And that is what brought me to London. It wasn't my job, but it was actually my, let's say, love. So I gradually started living more and more in London, and I had to find myself a job. So still thanks to my old professor, he introduced me to a dermatologist in London, which I could shadow. At least I was like doing something and be introduced to the world of dermatology in London. He had a clinic in Harley Street. I worked with him for a while, and then I was offered a job in a clinic in Harley Street. This was in 2004. I started working in this clinic, and then in 2005, when I realized that part of my life would be in London, I started building my own private practice here in London. And since then, I've been gradually and slowly building my practice up. In 2008, when I became pregnant of my first child, and at that point I was super sure that my life would be in the UK, I applied for a job in the NHS, and I started working with Professor Tony Chu at the Imperial College, and I worked with him from 2008 to 2018 when he retired. I then continued working in the NHS till 2020, when during the pandemic, for various reasons, I decided to resign. So at the moment, I am only working in private practice, both in Italy and in London. During all these years, so since 2004 that I started working in the UK, I managed to keep my clinic going in Florence, at the beginning, I'd go back every other week, and then gradually I started going every 2 weeks. And now I spend 3 weeks in the UK and 1 week in Florence to try to keep it going. It's been fantastic. It's been a challenge, but it's given me huge satisfaction having, let's say, my life in two countries. And the only big problem has been during the pandemic where I couldn't travel as much, but I kept it going, bit on video. And then finally, I started going back as frequently as I could to see my patients. So yes, it's been a fantastic, I'd say, 15 years living in two countries and managing two clinics.
Amazing, Benedetta. Tell me what motivates you in all of this? Keep both clinics going.
The main thing is that I'm an expat in the UK and I always will be Italian, and Florence is my home. So in my mind, the best way to have a constant reason to go back is a job. And it's the only excuse I can have with myself to leave my husband and my kids every 3 weeks, disappear for a week, and go back home. So let's say I'm settled in the UK, but to a point, I still feel that Italy is my home. And I want to keep a foot over there so that at any point in time I can go back. And also it makes me really feel happy to be able to go back. So it's like the fact of being able to manage two lives, two countries, two jobs has kept me going. I don't think I'd be able to live at this point of my life just in one place forever. Maybe not Italy, maybe not the UK, but I have to keep both things going. So that's my biggest drive.
What is it that you love about your job, Benedetta?
The various things I like about my job. First of all, it's a very practical job. I like to do things. So I love surgery. I love helping people. So my dermatology part is like sorting out people's conditions, helping them curing skin cancer, curing tough dermatological conditions that can make people's life pretty difficult and uncomfortable. And I've always found that very, very, giving me lots of happiness. On the other hand, I do lots of cosmetic dermatology, which is another way of making people happy, because people want to look good, especially now with all these social media and working on Zoom, and people feel not secure. And just a little bit of help can make people much more confident in themselves and happy. So, yeah. I like that. And also working in the cosmetic world, I see that very often things can go wrong. And I'm the kind of person that can say no to patients, that can make them realize what they really need and when they go over the top. And I really care for my patients. So I don't want them to go over the top. And I'm scared because sometimes they go elsewhere and they come back and they say, oh my God, what have I done? This is too much. You were right. And I'm like, yes, it's always less and more. You have to be careful. Don't overdo things. And I'm quite happy to stop people as well, not going over the top. So, I really care about this side of my job.
I love that, Benedetta. What do you think is your superpower? What do you have that makes you so good at what you do?
Well, very difficult to say that about yourself. I think it's because I'm very blunt and I'm very honest to people. And I think they appreciate that. And also I try to create a caring environment. So people are looked after. So also the people I hire, I make sure that they're responsive and they're empathic to people. So I want them to answer the phone all the time. I reply to text messages if they sent me, even on a Sunday in the evening or a Saturday evening. I try to communicate to my patients and be present. So I'm not only there when you come and see me in the clinic, but I try to be there all the time, which sometimes is overwhelming for me, but I think it gives patient comfort. So I think that is one of the things I might do differently from some of my colleagues.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure. You'd have to ask my patients what the real reason is and if they agree.
Definitely feeling safe with you. That's a sure top one. Good. Benedetta, what would your top tips be for other women?
In business, I think women should really try to have a career, do what satisfies them, grow kids, and that's fine. But in order to have a happy family, I think they have to be satisfied themselves. So don't give yourself up is my main message, is try to do what you want in life. Reach what you want. Don't let anything stop you. Your children are super important, but they will leave. And when they leave, you will need to have a life. You will have a husband that can support you. But ladies, you have to be self-sufficient. You have to be independent. And that's what I tell my daughter. You have to rely on yourself. Never rely on others. Be satisfied. Try to achieve what you can, and not be selfish, but if you think of yourself and make yourself happy, I'm sure the people around you will be happy as well. If you sacrifice yourself too much, you'll be frustrated, and people will not necessarily thank you for that. So I think that's the message I would like to give the young girls, especially. Don't be selfish, but make yourself happy first of all, and you know, persevere your dreams. Go ahead and do it.
That's a really good tip. Yes, thank you for sharing that. Benedetta, the last question would be, where do you see yourself in 5 years? What is your dream still to achieve?
Right. My dream still to achieve is, well, slow down at work, keep my job, but slow down a bit. And you know, I'm living now in the countryside, so I really enjoy having, you know, a little farm at home, all my little animals, look after them, I enjoy a little bit of a more calm life. So in 5 years, I think I will deserve working a little bit less, but working, if not, I'll get bored. Living more in the countryside, commuting for pleasure a bit more to Italy. And just, you know, slowing down the pace. I don't have any like wild dream of moving anywhere fancy. I really enjoy my life, but just slow down, because at the moment, I think it's just a bit crazy.
Oh, thank you, Benedetta, so much for sharing all this. Wonderful to chat to you.
Thanks, Stephanie. And good luck for your new adventure.
Thank you.
You'll tell me more about it as soon as possible.
Yeah.